As a video editor, I've had my fair share of tedious tasks to do. One of those is masking people's faces out. You'll have to blur them because you don't have permission for the face, or maybe you just want to create some drama. So you drag on a blur effect, you create a mask, and then you have to wait for it to track over a series of frames. This can be extremely time-consuming, especially if you have a lot of shots that you need to do this on. This is where Continuum 2024.5 comes into play, and our new Witness Protection ML. What you do is you drag the effect onto the clip, it's going to detect the faces for you and automatically track them instantaneously. I'll also show you what to do when the auto tracking isn't perfect. Let's see how we can use Witness Protection ML in Continuum 2024.5. So I'm inside of Premiere Pro right now, and I'm just playing back the clip that I would like to apply Witness Protection ML to. I'll park myself on a frame here, just in the middle of the shot. I'm going to head over to my effects tab, where I'll apply the Witness Protection ML effect. I've already done a search for it. You're going to be able to find it in the BCC Match Move section. And since my clip is selected in the timeline, I'm just going to double click the effect. And right now I can see in my program monitor, all of these faces have been blurred simultaneously. Not to mention blurred on this one particular frame, but tracked across the entire scene for where it detects these faces. I'll go back to the beginning of this clip and then just give a quick playback for this lovely blurred out faces here. All of them witness protected at once. I'll escape out of full screen playback. With my clip selected, I'll head over to effect controls. At the very top, we have a view setting that you can take advantage of, where instead of seeing the output of what witness protection has done with the default blurs, we can see the face detection mat. So these are each of the individual faces it picks up. We can also see it as an overlay, which would present you this just as a green color tint for the face detected area. I'll set this to output. Here under the face detection ML section, notice that we can of course disable the face detection altogether, which will just present you with the blur. And we can also make changes to that blur. So right now I'm going to increase the feather to a value of 10, but also increase the scale size of the face detection to 115 in this case, to make sure that most of my talent is covered up. We can also adjust the scale independently in both width and height. And we've got different modes for our obscuration effect. So right now, the blur amount is set to 50, but I'll set that to 0. Instead, we could have a mosaic. So I'll increase that size in this case to 51. We could change the size of the mosaic on both the X and Y value, but also scramble it, which will give you a slightly different mosaic pattern on this chosen frame. In addition to mosaic, we can mix in blur and also a tint color. So in this case, I'll increase the default red tint on this shot, and we can see there that it's applied over top of the mosaic. In this case, I'm just going to lower the mosaic size and increase the blur amount again to a value of 20 and change the color of the tint to an orange. And those are mixed together to give us the end result. As you can see, this can really speed up the process of you having to be able to blur out people in a shot by simply dragging and dropping this effect onto your desired clip. Now, let's just say one of two things occurs. There are some people on the outside of the frame where I don't want this witness protection to affect, or alternatively, maybe witness protection isn't perfect. It accidentally identifies a face that isn't really in your frame. In this specific shot, I want to witness protect the subject here. And let's just go right away and apply witness protection. We can see it does its job. But if I look at this carefully, I can see that there's a couple blips that happen on the left-hand side of the frame. In our effect, there is a section here called Mocha Mask and Track. And if I twirl this down, we'll get into Mocha in a second. There's a section called Pixel Chooser. And one of the advantages of turning this on is we can add another shape mask or gradient mask to the mix of our existing witness protection ML. In this case, I'm going to choose the mask section, and I'm just going to add a shape, in this case, I'll make it a rectangle just for you to see what the rectangle looks like. I'll turn it on. You can see it encompasses the majority of the frame. Now, white is where we want to see this effect, while anything black is where we don't. This rectangle is too big. So what I'll do is go down to the scale section, and on the x-axis, just try to get where the cop is in the frame, turn off the mask, and then just scrub through to see that that blip no longer occurs where it does. And of course, all of this can be keyframed. Now, as I mentioned in the beginning, witness protection ML is not always perfect. And there are going to be situations where it's going to fail on some of your shots, potentially due to the color information or movement within your particular shot. Let's take this shot, for instance. I'll just play it back so you can see the rotation as well as subtle scale movement occurring. We also saw some shadows move across the lower side of the frame. I'm going to escape out of there, head to my effects panel, and apply witness protection to the shot. It did see all four of these faces. However, we can see that the blur masks itself are adapting just due to some of the lighting changes as well as movement in your shot. So in a case like this, we can still use this effect. And the trick is to go to your effect controls and disable the face detection ML. Once you do this, you're at the will of then applying another form of mask. So in this case, we could use a Premiere Pro native mask, or even better, head to the Mocha mask and track section. And I'm going to go over here to Mocha mask. Now inside of Mocha, what I'll do is use it to create a shape mask around just one of these subjects' faces and track that manually. I'm going to select the magnetic spline tool. And let's use this to follow around the contours of the subject's face here in the lower portion of the frame. Now, one thing is, if you ever use this magnetic tool, it tends to add a lot of points to your Mocha mask, which might not be required. That's easy. You could select some of the ones that are unneeded and simply delete them all at once and then make adjustments. Or alternatively, you might want to use the Mocha X-Spline tool. Now that we've created a shape mask, let's head over to the Essentials tab here, where we've got our track motion options. In this case, the primary movement is going to be translation, scale, and rotation. You can just move through that just to make sure there is no skew or perspective changes. Doesn't seem like this face in particular moves. So let's now track this movement backward. Now, as this continues, I can see that the mask is drifting a little bit, but that's fairly easy to just move forward to the point of the drift and then make changes to the mask on that specific frame. The magic about this is because Mocha keeps that shape and track data separate, it's going to interpolate between the first keyframe, which represents the frame where you created the original mask, and now this new keyframe, which is where we made those changes. You'll see that it adapts perfectly. I like having to do this inside your NLE frame by frame. Let's track further backward. I'll make adjustments here to the left side of the mask and then move back to the frame. And then again, move back to the first frame where I began the track and start to track forward. And just to note, I can use this one piece of tracking as the base for tracking all four faces if required. And now that I'm happy with this mask, I'll close out Mocha, make sure to save, and heading back to Premiere Pro, see that that mask carries on over. So let me just move to the first frame of this clip and make this full frame. Obviously, we can see that this mask is a little bit harsh on the edges, and under my effect controls, in this case, if we go under Pixel Chooser Mocha, that's where we're going to want to adjust the feather properties. So here, I'll head to the mask section, seeing that it's using a Mocha spline in this case, because we headed over to Mocha, and then this feather this out completely. If we needed to, we could also invert the mask. I wanted to show one more example of how witness protection ML can be combined with Mocha masking. In this particular shot, I've made all of the faces it's picked up nice and big here that we can see by these blue circles, but it is also getting a bit confused here in the window, but where it sees faces here from these cardboard cutouts. In this particular case, what I'm going to do is go to my Mocha mask and track Mocha mask and grab my rectangular selection tool where I will define the area which I don't want witness protection to affect. Since this is a static shot, I don't even have to track this, but in the case that it was moving, of course, I could use one of several methods. Now that that's defined, let me close out Mocha. I'll choose to save to bring this over to Premiere Pro. And we'll now see that this is just defined to the window. Under witness protection, if we head into Pixel Chooser Mocha and go into our mask settings, we can easily invert this mask. And now all we see are the faces down here, which we would like to keep witness protected without affecting the problematic area. If we needed to blur out another face, we could head back to Mocha, create another shape and track that as well, and then hop back into Premiere Pro where we have witness protection completed on those two shots. As you can see, witness protection ML is gonna speed up the process of you being able to mask and track a face, blurring it out or using another combined look. Continuum 2024.5 has just been released and there are more tutorials covering everything that's new. Don't forget to subscribe and press that thumbs up button if you'd like more tutorials just like this.